too close.
Well, that's what we get for being ass deep. My car's on both sides of the line.
Why do we always get the easy jobs?
Don't know. Maybe it's Colonel Foley's way of saying he loves us.
Verluste in Sektor 6 und 7. Alle Einheiten zurückziehen zu Sektor 1. Ich wiederhole, zurückziehen zu Sektor 1.
Copy that.
Colonel Snyder, sir, we've been ordered to fall back.
What do you request? What do you request? I summon you.
My God.
As keeper of this amulet, I order you, come forth, child of darkness, and do my bidding. It's happening!
Colonel!
All right, this is the spot. Wolf, take point. Collins, cover the rear.
Which covers?
Sir.
Sergeant.
It's too quiet. I don't like it.
Well, you can take that up with Colonel Foley. This is the target. Take the private and clear the room. Collins, maps, documents, everything comes with us.
Yes, sir.
Sir? You okay?
I've had better days, Collins.
Lieutenant. Sir. Colonel Foley asking to see you, sir.
Lieutenant McNamara reporting as ordered, sir.
At ease, Lieutenant. I heard you lost a man tonight.
More than one, sir.
Well, I'm sorry, Lieutenant. The spooks are going over the intel you gathered, and we should know soon enough just how valuable it may turn out to be.
Yes, sir.
It's not all bad news, Lieutenant. The Krauts are growing desperate. Rumor has it that the German High Command is talking surrender. So with any luck, this whole damn cursed war could be over by Christmas.
Very happy to hear that, sir.
Good. Good work out there in any case.
Yes, sir.
Dismissed.
Shelling stopped. So quiet. It's almost peaceful.
Almost.
Is that picture of your girl, Lieutenant?
My wife, Josephine.
She's very pretty, sir.
She is.
Is that your reading?
Not reading nothing. Got no idea what kind of language this is. Took it off the crowd to Lieutenant Kiel tonight.
That's in German.
No. No, I never seen words like these before.
Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
Did I hear that right? You found that on the raid tonight?
I did, sir.
Why then did you not turn it in with the rest of the intel?
Well, this here ain't intel, Lieutenant. It's some kind of storybook or something.
Miss McNamara?
I am.
Name's Jimmy. I'll be your escort.
Oh, very nice to meet you, James.
Only two women call me James, my mother and sister Rafis, so please. Jimmy?
Jimmy.
Right this way.
Locking the doors. You know what Sister Rafis will say.
I need to show you something. Close the door.
What are you doing?
This is alchemy.
What's alchemy?
Miss Lita told me about it. She gave me this box. She says those who master alchemy can use it for all sorts of things. Potions to heal, to sleep, to make a boy love you.
What, like magic?
Yes, exactly. Here, let me show you. Love and healing magic. Two parts willow tree bark, one pinch of rosemary, a dash of dried apple ground into a paste. In small doses, it will heal infection and fever.
Fairy guardian conjuring. Call upon the fairies in darkness of light. Fairies? Really, Adelia, you shouldn't bother with... What are you two about?
Nothing for you to bother with, Ida.
Henrietta and Adelia, why are you not at choir?
Oh, I'm so sorry, sister. We were just about to leave.
What's that you're reading?
Oh, nothing. It's a book I found. It's...
Do Give it here. Secrets of the fairies. Potions. Remedies. Really now? Where do you find such rubbish, girls? Oh, you need not answer. This is Miss Lena's doing, is it not?
Oh, never mind.
You've each earned a demerit. Adelia, I believe this is your second this week.
It wasn't Henrietta's fault. She was just...
Silence, child.
Yes, sister.
Off to choir now, both of you.
Yes, sister.
Yes, sister.
What's it about, sister?
Never you mind, Ida.
Very well. Is there anything more I can help you with?
Yes. You can go to choir with everyone else.
Yes, sister.
New teacher.
Really? Now, let me see. Oh, yeah. Yeah, she'd do in a pinch.
In a pinch?
Oh, never mind.
Good heavens, what happened here?
Something at breakfast didn't sit well with this young one.
And why are you cleaning it up?
It's no bother, sister.
Your duties are to keep clean the kitchens and the lavatories. The children are responsible for their rooms.
Kitchen's clean. Same with the privies.
Nonetheless, we strive to teach personal responsibility here. Lena, stop this at once. And stand and face me when I address you.
How may I be of service?
You can start by explaining this. I found Adelia with it, and I can only guess that it was you that gave it to her.
It's just a bit of fun, ma'am. It's harmless enough.
Potions and spells. It's blasphemy. I won't have the children exposed to such indignity. I tolerate your peculiarities because you have a way with the children, but there are limits I will not allow you to press. Have I made myself clear?
You have, sister.
Excuse me, sister, but the young woman is here. The history teacher from Tucson, Miss Josephine McNamara.
Oh, yes. Where is she?
In Father Timothy's office.
Very well.
Miss McNamara?
Yes. But it's Mrs. McNamara. Sister?
Mary Rafis. Oh, please. Sit.
Excuse me, but I was told I'd be meeting with Father Timothy. He and I have been corresponding by mail for some time now, and I...
It was I who wrote those letters in the good father's name. Oh, there's nothing amiss. Father Timothy is very old, and his health is fading. And he's vested me with those burdens now beyond his capacity to manage.
I see.
Does that trouble you?
Not at all, ma'am. Sister?
Sister will do.
Yes, sister.
And what of your husband? Would he approve of his pretty young wife tending a gaggle of unfortunates?
Well, I'm sure he will, once I tell him. Patrick is a kind-hearted man. And I expect he will commend my decision to work here. Only, it's been some time since I've received news from him, as he's stationed in France, near the front.
He's a soldier.
Yes.
I see. May God protect him.
What do you think you're doing?
Sitting down to eat.
Not here, you're not.
There's plenty of room.
I prefer to dine alone. Thank you. Not hungry, Violet?
Not for this.
It's not that bad today. I wish we could say the same thing about the company. Don't look at him. Maybe he won't bother us.
Hey, Delia. Had another dream about you last night. You were naked.
You're a pig, Jack Larson.
This never works, but you never stop trying.
I'm persistent. I thought women like that kind of thing.
Not this one.
Well, how about you, Henrietta?
Not even if you were as rich as Midas.
There's Bram. Let's go mess with him.
Why don't you just leave him alone?
Why don't you worry about yourself, Adelia? What do you say, Jack?
I'm sorry, my lovelies. We're gonna have to continue this later.
What you reading, Bubsy? Who are you fooling? Oh, I can't read.
I like to look at the pictures.
Are there any nudies in there?
Give me that. You look like you want to hit me. Go ahead. Do it. I want you to.
No, I think he's gonna cry.
That right? You gonna cry? See? His brain's not all that soft about him.
On this floor, we have our dormitory.
Two children, two rooms.
He's the one that started this, sister, I swear.
That's not true. All he was doing was reading when they started laying into him. Yeah, it's true. We saw the whole thing.
Silence, everyone. What sort of cowardice is it to beat a boy 2-on-1? Help him up, girls. I don't know who started this, but both of you boys have just earned a demerit. Go and take Bram to Sister Martha. And the rest of you, go back to eating your lunches. Still sure you want the job, Mrs. McNamara?
We were supposed to take him to Sister Martha. What could Sister Martha do? The woman's half blind.
let that sit.
What is it?
Just a recipe of my own.
It stinks.
I know. But it heals, and that's the important part. By morning, it'll be as if it never happened.
Really?
How do you feel, Bram?
Like I just got trampled on.
From what I hear, told you were very brave.
Brave?
Mm-hmm. That you walloped that Virgil good.
Yeah, and if Jack didn't blindside you, it would be him in here.
I wouldn't help him.
Why not?
Boy's a bully. And just like you, I've been fighting him off my whole life.
Really?
Really. Now you all better get out of here before Sister Rafis gets wise to us. Keep Bram out of her sight until morning.
Thanks, Lena.
Yes. Thank you.
You're very welcome, Bram.
Sister Rafis?
Well, I went right to my head. Who are you?
I'm sorry, Father. I was looking for Sister Rafis.
Well, this is her office, more or less, so that's not a surprise, but you're that new teacher she hired, I'm guessing.
I am, sir.
Well, I was just saying there. Come on down and join us for a snoop.
Now, I can't.
Fair luck to refuse a holy man's hospitality.
Well, fetch. Well, young lady, would you like to join us in a libation?
Very well.
That's the spirit.
I gotta warn you, this is back in heat. That'll scorch a faint heart. A lady after my own heart. Would you like another?
I'm afraid I must decline. Tomorrow's bound to be a challenge enough without adding to it the misery of a hangover. Well, good evening to you both.
And to you.
You know, the best way to avoid a hangover is don't stop drinking. When it came his time to buy, he stamped up and said, show me the way to go home.
This one.
Of such carelessness as it looks to have attracted some gentleman callers.
I'll be more careful.
Good night. Mrs. McNamara.
Sister.
It's time for morning mass.
Malachi chapter 3, verse 1. The Messenger of the Covenant. Now I am sending my messenger. He will prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek will come suddenly to his temple. The Messenger of the Covenant, whom you desire. See, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters of Christ, it's a Christmas holiday. Nearly among us. We must give thanks. We must be good among yourselves and rejoice.
It appears that Father Timothy is unwell again this morning, but take heed of his message. Be kind and good to one another, for Christmas is a season of kindness and fellowship. Isn't that right, Father?
Oh, quite so, sister. Quite so.
Mr. John Adams was our second president, and he also signed the Declaration of Independence.
Mrs. McNamara?
Yes?
A word, please.
Excuse me, class?
Miss Josephine McNamara? I have a letter, ma'am, from Secretary of War Baker. It is with the deepest of regret and my most somber duty to report that your husband, Patrick, was killed in action on December 3rd while defending his post against the German attack. His selfless and heroic duties were greatly respected. I'm so very sorry, ma'am.
Return to your rooms now, children.
Hey, Jimmy.
What's that you're making?
Just something for that Mrs. Josephine to help her with her nerves.
Yeah. Talk about having a bad first day on the job.
Rough start, no doubt.
Think she'll be leaving us now?
Of course. How could she say after something like that?
I liked her.
But you didn't know her. None of us did.
I know, but she just had a way about her. It's hard to explain.
I understand what you mean, Bram.
Thank you.
I made you some fresh herb tea.
Oh, you're very sweet. Thank you.
It's Lena.
Oh, well, thank you, Lena.
Mrs. McNamara, if you should want to pray or talk to someone or anything at all, my door is always open.
Thank you, Father. Perhaps later.
Yes, of course.
Still with that damn book?
I can leave if you want.
Sorry. Just, I'm needing some affection.
Shut up, Billy.
What is that anyway?
It's ancient writing, pagan letters.
And the other one? Ancient alphabets. Translations and definitions. Where did you get these?
It's quiet. I'm trying to concentrate.
You swiped those from that old drunk's library?
There. I think I can make it out now.
Make what out? What the hell are you talking about?
Winite admiak tenebras. Vocali ex kinere.
Come again? You're a witch.
Really think so?
Get on out of here.
Wait. Billy, come on out. This isn't funny, Billy.
He arrived in the dead of night.
He has a strange way about him.
Guess he's not hungry.
Guess not.
But there's something else. No one can find Ida. Maybe she flew away in her broomstick. I heard she ran off with a boy.
A boy?
Who? Some townie she's been sneaking off to see.
Ida, Miss Teacher's pet.
That's what they say.
Are you not hungry, child? Would you follow me then to Father Timothy's office? We have much to discuss.
Operator.
Yes. May I have the train station, please?
Hold, please.
Southern Pacific Station?
Yes. When does the next train depart?
It's Christmas Eve, ma'am. And you've just missed the last one till after the holidays.
I see. Thank you.
And from this time being the age before the dawn of man, the spirits of old, the gods of elemental power over the universe, the servants of the divine where the fairies had conjured a being of pure evil. They called this beast the Krampus.
Have a seat, please. Very well. What can you tell me of yourself? You can start with a name. Who are you? Are you unable to...
Nicholas.
Nicholas. And what is your last name?
Nicholas is my name.
No last name? Where are you from?
Where do you think you're going, Lena?
Get out of my way, please. I need to speak with Sister Rapist. Sister, I must warn you.
What's come over you?
We're all of us in the gravest of danger.
Lena, good heavens. She's running a fever, but there's something else.
Something else?
She hasn't opened her eyes since she collapsed.
Is there anything you can do to help, Sister?
You can pray for her and stay out of Sister Martha's way.
Yes, Sister.
Do you hear me, Adelia?
Yes.
Let's go, children. We need to let Lena sleep.
Sister?
Mrs. McNamara, I thought Jimmy was taking you to the train station.
No more are running until after the holiday.
I'm sorry. You should be with family after receiving such news.
Perhaps you have some work I could do to keep myself occupied? Anything I could do to help you or Sister Martha? Perhaps something of Lena's? I know she's taken ill.
I really think it's best if
you
just...
No, please, Sister. Any task, anything at all,
Scrubbing floors would be heaven compared to sitting in my room alone.
Some of the children are decorating the Christmas tree. I'm sure they would be grateful to have someone tall enough helping them.
Very well, sister. Thank you. Oh, hello, young man.
You've been crying, but not for Lena. Who is it you cry for? Your husband? He was a soldier, was he not?
He was, yes.
Then why the tears? Soldiers die all the time.
Use sound warning if you see anyone.
Why? And what are you doing here? I thought we were going to see Henrietta.
No. Well, not yet anyway. Just stand here, Bram, okay? Keep your voice down low. It'll be okay. Just call out to me if you see Sister Raphis or anybody.
Do you even know how Santa manages to visit us every year when we have such a little chimney?
That's how he comes in, through the chimney.
But he's so fat. How does he fit?
He's magical.
I know she's mean most of the time, but I'm worried about Ida.
Is that the girl who's missing? I hear she ran away with a boy.
She does that every night when she thinks I'm sleeping. She always comes back.
What? You want to make something of it? Shrimp?
What's going on here?
Rachel tripped the new boy.
I didn't know such thing.
That will be quite enough.
Can you just leave it alone, Virgil?
Sleep tight tonight, kid.
Locked me out again?
Lock it behind her, please.
The book Lena gave you. Sister Raphis gave it back to you?
Not exactly.
Adelia, you should-
We need to help Lena. Whatever's wrong with her, I doubt it's anything Sister Martha can cure.
But this book, it's full of recipes. Let's see, Gifts of Mother Goddess, The Healing Arts,
The Mending of Broken Bones? Yeah. No. To restore a person's sense of smell. Oh, no.
Oh, here. To awaken someone from an unnatural sleep, use one part rosemary, one part sage, one part lavender, and one tale of a needful creature.
What's a needful creature?
It looks like a rat.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, there's a lot of rats at the back house. I can go get them.
I'll come with you.
Please be careful, you two.
Jimmy.
Father?
drop of the creature.
A little early for me.
Timing couldn't be better for me. Good afternoon, sister.
Father. And my sense of smell hasn't faded with age, so there's no need for pageantry. It is with you, James, that I wish to speak.
All your sister?
I'm worried about Ida. Sally tells me she's been sneaking off to see that Miller boy again, but it's not like her not to come back.
Young love.
I want you to go into town and inquire after her whereabouts. Start with that Miller boy. Find out where he lives, and if she's with him, tell her we only wish her to return and all will be forgiven. Well, she'll have to be punished, naturally, but we will forgive her. After all, I was young once myself. What?
Didn't say a word.
I'll be off then.
Happy hunting.
Good day to you, Father.
Where's your stocking, Miss Josephine?
Time for bed now, little ones. You don't want to be awake when Santa Claus arrives.
But it's so early.
Wait, what was that? Did you hear that, Mrs. McNamara?
I think I did.
Sounds like reindeer. Not very far, wouldn't you say?
Very close.
Nicholas. It's time for bed now, child.
Is it ready yet?
I think so.
Did you find out anything?
Nothing. I found the boy's father, but he hasn't seen or heard from him since yesterday. My guess is the two of them ran off together.
Oh, that's just not like her.
You think you know people, but...
It's been such a trying day. What with this news of Mrs. McNamara's husband and Ida running off and that strange child, Nicholas, just arriving at our door.
I can widen my search tomorrow, check the surrounding town, see if anyone's taking sight of him.
Tomorrow is Christmas Day, James, and your place is here with us. It saddens me that Ida has forgotten hers, but that was her choice.
Good night, sister.
Good night, James.
It's not working. Well, maybe we're not doing it right. What does the book say again?
Apply to the fingertips of the one that's lost in slumber. But nothing's happening.
Are you sure we're doing this
Adelia,
right?
Adelia, we need to hurry. Sister Martha will be starting headcount soon, and if we're not in our rooms, you know
I know!
Thank you.
Where's Bram?
Don't know. But if I were you, I'd go check Adelia and Henrietta's room.
Adelia! Bram!
It's not gonna work, Adelia.
Bram!
Adelia! The sisters are looking for us.
Henrietta? Adelia? Children doing in here?
Where?
Stay with me, girls.
What was that noise?
It sounded like Jack and Virgil.
It's happening.
What's happening?
He's here.
Virgil?
Jack!
Bram, get me that book.
Lena? What's happening? Lena!
Spirits of light, shield us from the darkness, fend off the forces of evil.
They need help.
No, Bram, don't go. Girls, take my hand. Bram, you two, we need to form a circle.
Why do we need to form a circle?
Just do what I say and repeat after me. Spirits of light, shield us from the darkness.
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 What is that?
Don't look, just
repeat
after me, keep going.
Spirits of light, shield us from the darkness.
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 Spirit of the light, shield us from the darkness.
Not all dreams are lies. Oh, my love. You need to hear me. You and everyone in this house in danger. For a lot of them, for many of them, it's already too late, but if you act now, you can still save the children. Wake up now. You have to wake up now. I'm sorry.
No.
I'm sorry. Hey, look to the amulet. It'll protect you. I'm sorry. You have to wake up.
No, you have to wake up. No.
No.
Jimmy!
Mrs. McNamara!
Father Timothy! What's happening here?
A beast. A demon from the bowels of hell.
I need to get you help.
No, no. Josephine, listen to me. It's taken the children.
What? Where?
Into the inferno. Josephine, you must help the children.
How do I help them?
Safe. Where did you get that?
It was among my husband's things. What is it?
It's the weapon we need.
For what? Just what is this thing we're fighting?
The Krampus. I need to find a counterspell.
Where is she?
taken her and all the other young ones I found in this place.
Taken them where?
Into the inferno. The realm of fire that lies between this world and the next. My home. And the source of my power. A power that grows ever stronger with every child I confine there.
And the others? Sister Rafis and Sister Bartha. Jimmy and Father Timothy? You murdered them! Why? What?
For the same reason the Huntsman slays the deer or the wolf devours its prey.
What do you say? That it's in your nature to murder us?
To punish you. That is my purpose. To take from you the children and act as harbinger to the darkness that will follow my return.
There has to be something, some way that we can speak out.
No, there is nothing. Prepare.
Goddess of water, mother, life giver, I call upon you. Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque. Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque. Children, just as before. Once more, we need to combine energy. Come on. Repeat after me. Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque.
Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque.
Again!
Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque.
Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque.
Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque.
Potestate Glacius, virtu
sacque.
It's working! Focus again, children!
Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque.
Potestate Glacius, virtu sacque.
Graham, get the book.
What is it you're waiting for, then?
Foolish mortal. So eager to die.
Tell her the truth, Krampus. You can't hurt her. She's the bearer of the amulet.
This is true. You, on the other hand, death to you.
Give me the amulet.
How?
Give it to me!
He's coming! Okay.
I need to catch my breath.
Where are we running to anyways?
As far away as we can get from that demon. Let's keep going.
No, we have the power. The power to defeat it, Lena told us so.
Lena didn't make it.
No, the power's in the amulet. All we need to do is use it.
How do we do that?
The book.
It's useless. She didn't even translate.
Wait, give it to me. Okay.
You think you can read it?
Ancient German, runic.
No one understands that.
No, wait, it's starting to make sense.
Really?
Yeah, I told Sister Rufus I wanted the chance to practice my studies. Well, here it is. Krampus Origins, a tale from the fairies.
How do we stop it?
Creation of the Krampus. No. Summoning stones.
He's coming. Hurry up. Come on.
Hurry up.
We need the amulet. Spirit of Fight. Pit and furnace. Awesome. Spirit of Finding. And in furnace. Hot absolutely. 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 Spirit of Finding. And in furnace. Hot
Somebody finds it.
We can only hope that day never comes. I wish I knew you better, sister. But your life's work lives on through these children. I have no doubt they will grow up to be fine men and women. Most of them, anyway.
Hey, Bram.
What do you want?
Adelia told us what you did. How you and her helped out Miss McNamara and destroyed that thing and brought us all back.
I did everything I could, but it's Miss Lena you should be thanking.
If only we could. I guess what we're trying to say is we're really sorry about how we made sport of you. And
if we could, we'd like a chance to start over as friends. Friends?
Why not?
Thanks, Bram. And Merry Christmas.
It's Christmas yesterday.
Yeah, well, I guess we kind of missed it.
Yeah.
Hey, Bram. Whatever happened to your stutter?
Don't know.
Those are very pretty flowers. I'm sure Lena would agree.
It was her favorite. She used to say the flowers continued the magic of the fairies. I love them all, but I'm gonna miss Lena the most.
Well, she's in good company, at least. I hope she and Sister Raphis can get on better in heaven than they ever did here on Earth. Maybe Father Timothy and Jimmy can help try to loosen her up a bit.
That's unlikely. And your husband?
Yes. Patrick was his name.
Patrick. You'll see him again one day.
I will. Just as you'll see Lena again one day.
Your husband's.
It belongs with a girl who understands magic, and I am the farthest thing from that.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.